Great day. We're up 150 points on the Dow, 1.2%. Who would be happy than the now finally back Mr. Neil Cavuto?
The Republicans in Congress are driving us toward the edge of a cliff, recklessly risking default, recklessly risking jobs in the American economy. They're willing to risk it all to protect tax breaks from millionaires, oil companies, and CEOs who fly around in corporate jets, even if the rest of us crash and burn.
Alrighty, what is it with cliffs? I'm gone just a couple of weeks and nothing changes. Over the cliff and now over the top.
Recklessly risking.
Welcome, everybody. I'm Neil Cavuto, and my thanks first to my colleagues and friends, Stuart Varney and Chris Cotter, for doing such great work when I was out these last couple of weeks. You know, it amazes me, though, that despite all the news that I missed, the one thing I did not, actually two things, the fear-mongering and the driving us off the cliff thing. In this latest ad out today from the Service Workers Union and a liberal group called Americans United for Change, no change, same old thing, Republicans are recklessly risking defaulting on our debt and driving our economy right off the cliff. Off the charts. What is it with the liberals and cliffs? Remember the one showing a guy looking an awful lot like Paul Ryan pushing a granny looking an awful lot like the late Harvey Korman off a cliff with Medicare cuts that were over the top? Look, I've been out for a couple of weeks, as I said, but it does seem to me that many liberals are just out to lunch, refusing to see that policies as they are the ones driving this country off the cliff. Now, it's not adjusting government spending that's pushing us over the edge. It's refusing to even address that spending. We're all going over the cliff because we are all out of money. And on the left, apparently out of ideas as well. That's what is so crazy here. Attacking anyone then who has the guts to say it's time to change things. Because the risk of careening out of control is alive and well, my friends. We have been perilously speeding along this dangerous highway for decades now. So I think it's time we kind of all wake up now, because every time we raise the debt limit and ignore what got us into raising the debt limit, we kind of hit our limit. And me, well, I just hit the wall. Take it from someone who's been missing work. These guys are just a piece of work. To South Carolina Republican Senator Jim DeMint, who's at the center of this fight and being criticized by many in his own party for being at the center of this fight and not accepting business.